Officiating at the event, the Principal Women in Development Officer at the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Idi Mubarak Mayanja, highlighted the fact that family is fundamental in child growth and development. He, however, exclaimed that the family institution is currently facing numerous challenges in fulfilling its functions as it is partly challenged by the increased employment of the women folk, an issue he thinks has been quite pivotal in regard to this subject.
It's challenging today for the modern parents to spare time, quality time for their children. This has caused serious negligence in child upbringing, which in return causes permanent torture, torment for both the parents and the children. So I call upon the parents to have valuable time for their children.
Mayanja further noted that the magnitude of gender-based violence in Uganda is widespread and affects all people, irrespective of their social, economic, and political status. For instance, the lifetime prevalence of intimate partner violence and physical violence among ever-partnered women was 45%, the highest being actually sub-region 78%, and sexual violence was 36%, with the highest being in the regions of actually 64% and Bukedi 61%. He says that child neglect and cyber harassment are on the rise.
Child neglect and abandonment has increased. Emotional violence amongst the children. And this has been reported that about 51% of men and 45% of women who are children, they are faced emotional violence, the street children we are seeing.
As gender-based violence remains an ailing subject in Uganda, the Men's Forum Against Domestic Violence has continued to rally men to disclose related violations and not to be silent. Men should also take up the services that are provided in the advisory centers across the country.
In every 10 men that we interviewed facing GBV, we discovered that only 5 of them have reported this violence somewhere. And this points to one thing, that there is still a great job to be done. Men must be made to feel that reporting violence does not make them less of a man.
As an alternative hopes to address the rising concerns around gender-based violence affecting men, Robert Ndaula, the program's manager of the Men's Forum Against Domestic Violence, has requested legislators to table a bill in Parliament proposing compulsory DNA testing in order to counteract violence cases that arise from the right parenthood of children. The forum also wants DNA testing charges subsidized.
We believe that once this is done, it will help to increase the fidelity in our homes. It will stabilize our families. And above all, it will reduce conflict among our family members, especially which occurs at the death of one of the family members. Ladies and gentlemen, we have seen bodies being exhumed, so that a DNA sample is taken. This should not be done.
On the latest progress, there has been an increased public awareness on gender-based violence as a human right at the family, community and national levels, an increased reporting of cases of gender-based violence from 39.5% in 2013 to 70% in 2021, according to the UBOS National Survey on Violence Against Women and Girls 2021. These have been attributed to the innovative approaches the Gender Ministry has undertaken to have toll-free lines, Sauti 116, SafePal app, and the robust referral pathways for violence against children and gender-based violence. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.